to share the knowledge and to get equipped.
To clarify the doubts peeped out from our young minds.
Now I humbly request our chief guest, Padmashree Mylswamy Annadurai sir, to interact with the students to empower them with your knowledge and experience. Please, sir.
கேள்வி தயார் பண்ணிட்டுருக்கீங்களா? தயாராக இருக்கா? தயார் பண்ணணுமா? ஆ, இப்போ கேள்வி கேட்குற நானா நீங்களா? யார் கேள்வி கேட்கலாம்?
சார், as ma'am said, is science a boon or bane for man?
ஓகே, so this basically how you take it, okay? இப்போ வந்து நிறைய சயின்ஸ் அப்படிங்கிறது என்னன்னா பேசிக்கலி டூ திங்ஸ். ஒன் இஸ் த சயின்ஸ் இஸ் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் யுவர் என்விரான்மெண்ட் அண்ட் யூ, தட் த பேசிக் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங். தென் ஹேவிங் அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் தட், அறிவியல் தொழில்நுட்பம் அதை வந்து நீங்கள் எப்படி பயன்படுத்தலாம் அப்படிங்கிறத பல இதில் வந்துருங்க. இப்போ தீ எப்படி வந்துச்சு அப்படின்னு பார்த்தாங்க, பார்த்துட்டு தீயை உருவாக்குனாங்க. ஓகே, இப்போ தீ வந்து உங்கள் கேள்வி பிரகாரம் போகலாம். ஓகே, இப்போ தீ எடுத்துக்கங்க, தீ அப்படியே வச்சுருந்தோம்னா இந்த அளவுக்கு நம்ம வந்திருப்போமா? தீ மட்டும் எடுத்துங்க, வேறு எதுவும் வேண்டாம். முதல் கண்டுபிடி மனிதன் தீ தான். அந்த தீயை பார்த்துட்டு பயந்துட்டு இருந்தான், அதுக்கு பிறகு தீ எப்படி உருவாக்குறதுன்னு பார்த்தான். அந்த தீ தான் நம்ம வீட்டில் பண்ண காலையில் என்ன சாப்பிட்டீங்க, மறந்துட்டீங்களா?
லெமன் ரைஸ்
ரைஸ் வயலிருந்து வந்துச்சு. அது சாப்பிடக்கூடிய வகையில் உருவாக்குறது என்னது? அம்மா சமைச்சாங்க. சமைக்கிறதுக்கு தீ இல்லாமல் சமைச்சிருக்க முடியுமா? முடியாது இல்லையா? இப்படி ஒவ்வொரு நாளும் இப்போ வந்து தீ வந்து பல வகையில் உதவுது. அந்த தீயை வந்து எப்படி சரியாக பண்ண அப்படின்னா, அந்த தீயை வேறு மனுஷன் இன்னொருத்தர் பக்கத்து வீட்டுக்கு தீ வச்சான்னா அது தீயினுடைய குறையா மனுஷனுடைய குறையா?
மனுஷன்.
ஆ, அறிவியல் தப்பு இல்லை இல்லையா? அதுக்கு அது எப்படி அறிவியல்கிறத வந்து ஒன்றை புரிஞ்சுக்கிட்டு அப்புறம் நமக்கு உயமாக பண்ணுறது. சிறுசை முதல் கண்டுபிடிப்பு தீ, அப்படி ரெண்டு உறைஞ்சதுனால வந்துச்சு, அப்புறம் சிக்கிமுக்கெல்லாம் தீ உருவாக்குனா அந்த தீயை வந்து தனக்கு தேவையானபடி சமையலுக்கும் பல இதுக்கு உபயோகப்படுத்த ஆரம்பித்தான். அப்படி உபயோகப்படுத்தாமல் மற்றவனுக்கு தீமைக்காக உபயோகப்படுத்தும் பொழுது இதாக போகுது, அவ்வளோதான். அந்த வகையில் அறிவியல் வந்து ஹவ் யூ டேக் இட்.
தேங்க்யூ சார். சார், குட் மார்னிங் சார். ஐ எம் சோ ஹாப்பி டு சீ யூ சார்.
மீ டு.
தேங்க்யூ சார். My name is Jayavashni, yeah. Studying 12th grade, biomax student. So I have a question. Apollo 11 lander Eagle was landed on the moon in Sea of Tranquility. Where did Chandrayaan 1 landed and where was Vikram supposed to land, sir?
Okay, basically Chandrayaan 1 point of view had two components. One was orbiter and there is an impact probe. The impact probe landed near the South Pole only. Yes, but that is called, we named as Javagardhan.
Jawahardhan.
So okay. That is a new place. That is the name. Because November 14th, Jawaharlal's birthday, yes, it has gone. It is a planned, targeted place, impact landing, not a soft landing. And similarly, now you look at here, this also like between two craters, we are supposed to land a place where this more so-called fertile region, near the South Pole only, 74 degree latitude. So not exactly South Pole, it is high latitude region in the, through the south. Between two craters, we are supposed to land softly. Mm. But unfortunately, due to technical snags, that didn't happen there. So from the intended place, as of now, at understanding is nearly 500 meters away. It has hard landed for the Vikram is concerned.
Okay, thank you so much.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah.
I am D. Vedavalli of 12th grade, Spark Metric. And this is my question. What is dark matter? And why does it not emit light?
Okay, basically look at here, this is to account for something. What happened in an equation when you are putting something you don't know, you claim is a x, correct, no? So similarly, the same thing happening here. So you look at here, the whole universe, we are able to account only a very fraction of the matter in the system. for the way in which you are trying to account the planetary motion, the way in which you are accounting the what would happen from there and it's going, okay? And matter supposed to be there everywhere. Okay, you got the point, no? We are not able to account a good fraction of the matter, we are not able to account it. We are not able, okay. That's how this is, you look at here, we talk about even Karundhulai, dark hole, Abdisulangliya. So that also, the mass, it's supposed to be a mass, but we are not able to see it, we are not able to do that. Now we are able to see, it's not its thing, it's effective point of view. Similarly, in the whole of universe, we are not able to account something. You got the point, no? We are not able to account that matter, which you are not able to see it also. So the property, whatever we are seeing is a system is there. It able to reflect the light. I'm able to see you because you reflect the light. When you are not able to reflect the light, I cannot see you. Correct, no? The dark hole also basically we told like that only. You're not able to, there's also, there is a matter supposed to be. But it's so that matter was so tense for some form, but not, we are not able to see it, that's why we told it. But the effects were seen, because of the effects, supposed to be a high gravity system, sir, we told about dark hole. Similarly, the dark matter is concerned, we are not able to account some of the masses. A great, great amount of mass, we are not able to account. So that should be a part of the system which you are not able to see. That's why it's all dark. Got the point, no? That's why we are telling about that.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, sir. My name is Prem Chal. I had one doubt, sir. I will stay young forever if I am in space, sir.
Okay, it's basically a hypothetical situation. So what we are talking about is, we are in a space only today. Okay, now you look at here, this world also. Now it is traveling in a space nearly 30 kilometers per second. You and me are traveling actually. You and me are in the really space travel. 30 kilometers per second, we are traveling. We are not even knowing. Okay, but only thing is, we have, because of the atmosphere, because of we are accustomed to that, we are relatively safe. Because of the various regions, we are safe there. Otherwise, we are all, even the whole, this earth is also in the space only, not that. But what you talk about is, when you're able to travel much faster. Okay, this travel, 30 kilometers per second, let us assume it touches 300,000 kilometers per second. Let us assume it touches that. Okay, if it touches, which practically not possible, if possible, okay, then we are talking about time can become standstill. Then you can be there. But this is a very very, as far as I am concerned, it's a very, very hypothetical situation. It's very difficult to touch that limit. If you're able to touch, yes, it's possible. But nothing to do with the space. Correct, no? We are already in a space only. It's not the space, the other way.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, good morning, sir. Myself, V. Vishweshwaran from Class 12 Biomax Group. And it is a great pleasure and honor to have such a legend in front of us. And thanks for the management to provide. And I have a great doubt. Why is it time is said to be constant in the black hole, sir?
Okay, this is what that's what I was trying to refer to him. It is not basically the black hole per se, the travel into the black hole. Okay, it itself is a myth, something like that only. I'm thinking about that. So then, first of all, the travel in that speed, when we talk about that, travel in the speed, time can become standstill. This is the way in which relativistically we are trying to explain the things. But now what is happening is, yes, the phenomenon is correct. For example, even for present the satellites, when navigation satellites, it's moving a fairly good speed. Okay, now even to fix the distance, basically it tells where you are, from the where it is there, from there how much distance it takes time, with that we are able to correlate where you are. Okay, but now even that speed, with that speed, actually the time needs to be adjusted. Time dilation is supposed to be there. I'm talking about a practical situation and a situation where that limit, so-called limit, where time can become standstill, we extend this, that situation comes. That's why I'm telling that. So now what is happening is, if you don't account for the time dilation, that means when you're going faster, some sort of slowness in the time is coming there. If you don't account it here, for example, today you are being fixed one place. Okay, you got the point, no? So the GPS tells like that. If you don't account the time dilation for that speed, which is only some few thousand kilometers per second, Okay, we don't account for that per hour. That if you don't account for it, then you are going to, you are making a mistake of nearly 7 to 8 kilometers. Today that we have seen that. This is practically we have seen. This is a practical situation. So where we are, our movement few thousands of kilometers per hour is a reasonably good thing practically. But now the same thing if you keep extending, you got the point, no? Whatever is happening is some delays keep on happening. That is, time is getting dilated. That means it's elongated. It goes to a situation where you're able to go, touch the limit of light speed, then time can become standstill. We are talking about that. But as far as I am concerned, it's a practically not possible situation. This is what we are talking about. Say, this is something like this, I will tell you. If 1 by 1 is 1, 1 by 2 is half, 1 by 3 is, we can keep on telling like that. Okay, but now 1 by 0, yes, theoretically is infinity, but this infinity is many places not possible. Mathematically it's okay, but theoretically, practically in many places we cannot tell that. Similarly, travel in the times light speed is practically not possible. Okay, but only thing is to extend, if you extend this to that limit, it happened like talking about that.
Thank you.
Sir, my name is M. Sarachandra. I am from grade 8, sir. I have a doubt, sir. Sir, do you believe that life exists in elsewhere in universe?
Okay, this is nothing to do with the belief. So you look at here, it's only just yourself, you question yourself, okay? So just I want to give practical. I want to give a practical. So for example, moon also, everybody told, okay, no water. Because they went and searched it, that places wherever the searched water was not there. That is also correct only. Practically, that was not there. But we only questioned ourselves, okay? Only very few places you have gone and sampled it. From there, we are telling no water and the moon. But unless otherwise search the whole moon, you cannot answer that answer of no absence of water in the whole moon. You cannot tell unless otherwise you search the whole moon. So that's why Chandrayaan, when it searched along with our 11-12 instrument, we are able to see many places water, but the places where elsewhere, US or Russia, somebody has told no water even today. But presence of water I have seen after exploring the whole moon. Correct, no? Similarly, unless otherwise you explore the whole universe, it's very difficult to tell no life in the universe. You got me what I'm telling now? So that we have not touched that little bit. Like our life limit, light limit to the speeding. Now, similarly, the exploration of the whole universe has not been done today. But what has happened is something like Earth, that is, there is a sun also another star. From the star, some distance. So many planetary systems are there, but this is compared to Mercury, Venus, or Mars. This is not very far, not very close. You got the point, no? This has enabled, this situation has enabled life to form in the Earth. You got the point? It's natural evolution. It's happened there. There are some conditions have come. So now, like Earth-like planets have seen exoplanet beyond solar system, not in our system. Earth-like planets, similar situation. So that planets we know it is there, but that in the planets life is there or not, we have not seen today. You got the point, no? Though we have not seen the whole universe, in the universe there are Earth-like planets. That there is a star, and the star is distant, something like this, going around the stars, the planetary system is there. So that systems, unless otherwise you exhaustively, like whatever we have seen in the moon, we don't do it, and before that we cannot tell. So as far as I am concerned, it is still 50-50 chance. Chance is there.
So, good morning, sir.
Yeah.
I am Mithun Karthik from 11A2 Computer Science Group. And my question is, why do we choose South Pole instead of North Pole for Chandrayaan-2 landing in the moon surface?
No, as far as I am concerned, North or South equally okay. Technical point of view, both are equally challenging, okay? But only thing is near south, there is a big crater. There is a big crater, Atkinson crater, something like that, you will tell there. So that crater, possibly after moon formed, some impact happened there. What happened, the moon, already many impacts are happening. some meteors keep coming and keep on getting there. That is the reason the whole system is the upper layer, very pulverized, very, very dusty type of thing it is there. But one place, something has come and hit and taken the mass away, okay? In the planetary system, it is somewhat recent. Recent means not a couple of years back, but recent means for in the planetary life age point type, it's recent that it is taken away. So that means that place, if you land, there is a possibility you will able to understand about the moon. That is like the core of the earth, if you see, we have not seen now, okay? Like that it's trying to see a possibility a few kilometers down, also you can see that. So that science point of view, we'll able to understand from moon, from where moon has come, and the solar system understanding possible there, okay? So science point of view, to understand it is better. But north or south pole, as far as pole is concerned, basically water resources are better there because of Chandrayaan finding. And south is, for this science point of view, it is a better place to land, to understand what the moon is. And over and above the communication point of view also, the season in which we landed there, it enable you much better way. So like that, one is science, another one is the communication point of view may be slightly better off. And water resources is better in the south pole. In future, man has to land. So man has to land in the place where the abundance of water is there. So all put together, it has come there. But otherwise, technical point of view, north or south, both are equally challenged.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, sir. I am Santosh. Is time travel really possible, sir?
So who want to answer this? Very good place, truthful place. That's why again told this question will come, I told. It's as far as I am concerned, with the present technology is very, very difficult. Okay, and whatever you do, what happened, you have to spend something to accelerate you. So you have seen the PSLV launch, na? PSLV, GSLV launch. It is stationary. So then it lifts off. When it lifts off, it slowly only takes a velocity. And that means every pound it spends, every kg of the fuel it spends, okay, with that fuel, it thrusting is happening. But the one which enables, the thrust remains same. Then your acceleration, you are able to put in maximum, put it there, that much only, that much speed only goes. But now let us assume when that speed is going on, you keep on reducing the mass. Keep reducing the mass, the fuel only. So with the proportion to that, it will accelerate slightly further, slightly. That's how your PSLV is keep on increasing its speed. Okay, that speed is happening. Then one stage itself falls. Like that, no? So now, what is happening is, to touch the limit of the speed of light, okay, you have to carry huge amount of fuel. Why I told practically not possible, that only. Huge amount of fuel with the present technologies. When that much fuel if you take, you cannot even lift. That's why I told, say, this is like 1 by 0, say 1 by 1, 2, 3, 4, like that you can go. Okay? Say, whatever mother is having a food, one, you can eat it. ரெண்டு பேர்த்து பங்கு பார்த்து கொடுக்கலாம், மூணு பேர்த்து பங்கு பார்த்து கொடுக்கலாம். வி மேக் இட் ஸோ மச் டிஃபிகல்ட், இன்ஃபினிட்டி, அது மாதிரி வருது இல்லையா? இது மாதிரி இங்கே அது என்ன ஆகுதுன்னா, ஸோ தட் மச் ஃபியூயல் யூ சுட் ஹேவ் டு தியரட்டிக்கலி டு அக்வயர் தட் ஸ்பீட். பட் இஃப் யூ ஹேவ் தட் மச் ஃபியூயல், யூ கனாட் இவன் லிஃப்ட், பிகாஸ் தேர் இஸ் அ ஃபைனைட் த்ரஸ்ட் ஒன்லி இட் கேன் கோ. வென் த்ரஸ்ட் கனாட் லிஃப்ட் த லான்ச் வெஹிக்கிள். ஸோ அன்டில் இட் கம்ஸ் டு எ மாஸ், இட் கனாட் லிஃப்ட். You got the point. Against the gravity, it cannot go. So once against the gravity go, it has far given the thrust. Thrust by mass is only acceleration. Thrust by mass acceleration, it's come even 0.001 itself. Okay? Given the thrust, mass cannot be something bigger. So big, it is near zero. You got the point, na? This many kilonewton of thrust divided by this many tons if you put it. So much of tonnage if you put it, you cannot take it. But if you make it less to take it off, so the fuel gets expended before it reaches 10 kilometer speed itself. But you are supposed to reach 3 lakh kilometer per second. So that much to reach, these two are all not possible. Not possible to connect practically. You got the point, no? That's the thing. Instantly acquiring the 300,000 kilometer per second is practically not possible. You have to give energy. So to give that energy for the given the mass, it's impracticable to realize that. That's all.
Thank you, sir.
Or else your mass should be as light as photon. With the photon mass, light comes because of that. But you cannot push it that way. That is the thing.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Nazara Fatima of 10th. And I have a question, that is, how do you calculate the distance and time of the space while launching the satellite to the orbital, sir?
Okay, this is what I told, no? So basically, science is more of an observation first. Observation and understand that first. And that means enough data collected from the moon, enough data collected from the Mars. These two objects alone, if you take it there. So now, moon, we know overall over the year, how it goes, what speed it goes, we know. And the given time, where is it? Also, we know pretty well. That's the target. But the target is not a fixed target. It's a moving target. Correct, no? So, but now, as I told sometime back, you keep spending the fuel, okay? You know each instant how much velocity you can acquire. Got it, no? So now, this way, that means to reach this fellow, we calculate it back from Earth, okay? How I have to travel. Straight line traveling is something impossible. Straight line traveling, okay? Because the speed, amount of speed what you acquire is huge. Instantaneous it go. Then only it's possible to reach. That instantaneous is not possible. But it needs a finite time. 386,000 kilometer or 316,000 kilometer, it varies. So to reach that point is concerned, okay, you have finite time you have to travel. But that travel straight line is not possible. But another thing is what we are straight line is you have to keep on accelerating, like your car is going. So that much fuel also we don't have. So instead of that, what is being done is, now your bird is coming, you know that speed is, that you infer what it is. But instead of that, you can calculate here itself, from here to here, 6.5 days there. That time, if you go this way, where you will be there, where the moon can be there. So this is, you have to back calculate. So this path is not a straight line path. This path also you can predict. Because the path is, like you throw a ball, normal calculations you're doing it, no? The 45 degree angle you put it there, accounting your gravity, so this also keep falling down. So when it reaches in that parabolic path, where it can hit, you can calculate. You extend similar thing in a computer simulation, you have your gravity, now you throw it from Earth, some altitude, some place, when you throw it that way, gravity of Earth is there, it will, like your moon is keep coming, it will also come back. So you travel this way it goes, correct, no? So, but when it's going, you should iteratively do a lot of calculations such that with this time when it's going, moon supposed to be there. So that means the path is clear, but path to intersect the moon, you should have a time. You will work out a time. That means that particular time, particular place, you give this much velocity. With this velocity, this path is going there. When that path comes, moon also will come close to that. Okay, but that point is known. So they having reached that point, then you should do another maneuver, because the same speed if you do, you cannot be around the moon's orbit, because the gravity of the moon is being less, same speed not possible. So at particular point, you have reduced the velocity. So this is purely back calculating the thing, and the, given the velocity profile, how the velocity profile will propagate and be there, and that time should be such that moon also should be supposed to be there. You already observed how moon comes. Okay, but that means when you know it's going over there, when it's being there, moon also supposed to be there, it cannot be every day. It is a particular day, particular time, from particular place. So that's being calculated there. So this, all this matching for this, we will do that. That is the way.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, sir. Yeah. My name is R. Harish. I am of grade 8. My question is, what made you think of exploring the moon, sir?
What made you the moon? That is the moon. Now, it is basically, the idea is something like this. Your chairman and director, what made them to make this annual conference today here?
Give education. Huh? Give education.
Yeah, to inspire you. Something like that, no? Education, daily the teacher, then teachers will tell what the teachers are not educated, what we are going to educate. That is not the thing. It's more than that, it's basically to inspire you. Okay, to inspire you to look for something. Something big, something dream, something like that, no? So now, something similar within ISRO, we are making so many satellites, okay? Like we are preparing for our exams, we are also launching so many satellites. But then on fine day, we thought routinely we are keep doing, we should have something to inspire us. What we will do? Okay, so that is something we should do, like sometimes you are being taken to tourism, no? Like that, what we can do? So then we thought, why can't we have a mission to the moon? To inspire us. Yeah, totally different. And not only that, to inspire the people to come and join ISRO also, much large number. Okay, the two things are there. People who are within the organization to inspire the people to attract from outside to inside. What we thought is, going our mission to the moon may attract the people. That's what we have done that. Say, we are launching, I was a part of more than 35 satellites. Have you ever heard about that remaining 29 mission? You know only Chandrayaan, Mangalyaan. Other things you don't know. Nobody bothered, no? Correct, no? But whereas Chandrayaan, Mangalyaan attracts you. So like that, so this idea is to inspire you inside and outside the people. Why can't we have the mission? That's the reason purely it came. But that being the idea, but how we can be different from there? So like all school are doing annual day, how you can be different from them? You have to do something, no? So that's why we have done a mission. Instead of landing on the moon, instead of going around the moon like this, we went around the moon like this with our own instrument. So this allowed to search the whole moon. Then only we are able to identify the water on the moon. So before to us, 769 missions gone to the moon. We only made discovery of water on the moon. Chandrayaan only has done that for the first time. Okay. So like that, this is to inspire us. And to see the possibility of whether anybody has missed it there. Okay, that's how we have done that.
Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. I am from 11th A1 Biomax student. I am so happy to see the former director of ISRO. Okay. My doubt is, what is the difficulties you faced while constructing Chandrayaan 1, sir?
Okay, constructing Chandrayaan 1, I cannot tell basically difficulty. It's a challenge. It's a challenge only, okay? Number one, even to make a project report, we cannot see what others have done, similar amount I cannot ask. That budget. Okay, whatever the budget other people are spending, we should make a budget as minimum as possible. So money was given was 1/10 money. But 1/10 money, but still, whatever they have done, that alone, if you do it, they will ask, already they have done it 40 years back. When I was a school kid itself, they landed on the moon. Then why we should do it here? Okay, so what difference, in spite of the money being less, what difference we can make compared to their discovery? These two points. One is, you are starting from low, but still your aim is more. So now connecting these two. You got the point, no? How to connect these two? So that, and again, our resource available is only PSLV. PSLV can lift not more than 1,050 kg and can put an orbit around 20,000 km only. But you have to go for, as your friend asked, you have to go for 384,000 km. Okay? To reach, you should have an innovative way of reaching there. This is the same things you can say. Okay, on reaching. But after reaching, what you are going to do? Just reaching alone will not help. After reaching also, you should, we thought it's a slightly different way. That's what I told. You have to go a polar orbit. But polar orbit, not many people have gone. That is a big challenge. Because as I told, moon is going around the earth nearly 1 km/s. That speed is going around the earth. But you have to go nearly 6 days travel will be there. Whatever may be the mode if you go. When it goes there, your moon is supposed to be there. And that too, if your moon is like this, if you go behind and come, there is a distance possible. But here you have to go above the pole only. Pole means you have to go above a point. That means 384,000 km away, there is a target. The target is a moving target. Over that you have to go. It's a challenge or difficulty, that's up to you. The biggest challenge, no? So that's then going around there, then you can go around the moon. But going around, as I told, is targeted place, our tricolor flag has to touch the Javagardhal. Until it touches, we should have communication. Otherwise, people will not believe. So 27 minutes it will travel, then it will go and touch the moon. So until it touched, we ensured that the communication to the mother craft is there, that it relayed back. So that has done its job. Remaining 1 year, it's supposed to see the whole entire portion of the moon. Just going alone, not enough. Then only we'll be able to see what elsewhere people have seen versus what we have seen, what difference. So that way, you look at here, starting from the 1/10th of the budget, starting from a very, very modest PSLV, reaching the moon around the pole, and ensuring you targeted place you hit the moon with the moon impact probe, and remaining 9 months with the other 11 instrument surveying, and going exploring the whole moon, and telling the world what moon is. I think we are the first ever people with that low money we have done that. So it's a real, I can tell you, it's a more than the challenge, it's a historical opportunity. We made use of the opportunity very nicely. One side we can tell it's a challenge, difficulty, but other side it's your own way you have done it.
Good morning, sir. I am Stephen S. of grade 9. I have one question, sir. Sir, like seeing, hearing, thinking, could people of other planets have any other powers we can think of?
Seeing, hearing?
Thinking.
I also don't know. Because we have to go there and we should ask them what they are doing. Of course, these are also got evolved. What you are telling is correct. As a human only, not every animal, okay? It also sees, I understand. It also hears. But thinking, whether they are doing or not, we don't know. They also may be thinking, but not to the level what we are thinking. So this also an evolution. It is not every generation thought like this. Even why I'm telling is, it all depends on the time series where you are. You put yourself 1,000 years back. You put yourself 10,000 years back. You put yourself even much beyond. That human being, he also could have seen. He also would have heard. But he also could have thought. But I doubt whether he would have listened like you. Whether he thought like you, we don't know. Okay. Got the point, no? The same human species over the ages got evolved. And today what he thinks and what he speaks and what he sees is different. Similarly, even if life is there, that life is in their time frame, where are they? We don't know. Okay? If such a thing is there, like sitting here, sitting in Bangalore, we are able to tell Mars, where is our Mangalyaan going, we are able to tell. Yes. For various ways. It is beyond seeing, it is beyond hearing, it is beyond thinking. We are seeing, no?
Yes,
which you are not seeing. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
You got the point. You got my point, no? What I'm telling?
Yes, sir.
So similarly, it all depends on the time scale where you are. Similarly, what time scale they are, we don't know. Let us assume they are 10,000 years ahead of us. Just imagine. They are 10,000 years ahead of us. Okay. If they would have evolved the same pace in which we evolved, so they would have been much more better. Whatever we are talking about, light travel, okay, the time travel, we are telling today practically not possible. I don't know whether they are touching that or not, I don't know. Provided their time scale is that way. If they are coming behind to us, it's different. So it solves anybody's imagination.
Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Where are you, ma'am?
I'm
fine.
Sir, I am Harita Vasavi of 6A. My question is about what meaning of CBSE of rocket.
What is it?
What is the meaning of C in PSLV C-37 rocket?
Okay, you are asking about C-37 rocket. So what is the C meaning you are telling about that? Okay. No, basically PSLV itself, basically originally we thought it was a polar satellite launch vehicle, but various purposes we are using. The original name remains same, that's where we are going it there. So now when we are talking about, then initially we talked about D, what development level things we talked about. When C is coming, it's small, for example, PSLV used for so many missions. 37 is 37th mission. You got the point, no? Similarly, the idea of C is for some of our people, it is a PSLV used for various family of satellites launch. It used for the, even for Chandrayaan it used, it's used for Mangalyaan we used, and for some meteorological satellite like Kalpana satellite, we used it. And resource satellite, we used it. Many remote sensing satellite, we used it. Now, this is being used for the Kato series satellite. So now onwards, within same PSLV, okay, even though it is used for many numbers tells what number it is going, C, now it is trying to designate for Carto series of satellites to go. That is the way. Cartography means you go and give the mapping of the whole Earth is concerned. That is the idea.
Thank you, sir, for accepting our request and sharing your knowledge with our school students. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.